I mean, there's so many songs about it, and L is for the way you look at me. So many songs about it. I'm too misty and too much in love. There's so many songs about, they're writing songs about love. There's so many songs about love. You think it would be an obsession. You think with all the songs about love, we would have matured to this level, but we're still saying, reach out and touch someone's hand, make this a world a better place. We're still saying what the world needs now is love, sweet love. Even with the preoccupation of love, and it's in, you know, whatever genre of music, there's love songs, you know, we sing about it, but we miss it. The Bible tells us to make love our highest aim. Make that a priority. Make it with everything that you do, that's the number one thing. The Bible tells us that whatever we do in word or deed, we do it in His name. It's also do it in love. Why is love so important? How can we make love our highest aim? Why do we need to make love our highest aim? Well, it says in the book of Matthew, in the 22nd chapter, you know, that we are to love God with all our heart, our soul, our mind, and our strength, neighbor, and to love our neighbor as ourself. Because when you operate in that kind of love, you don't have to worry about all the other commandments. Thou shalt not this, thou shalt not this, thou shalt not covet, thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not lie, thou shalt not steal. Because love is going to constrain you. You know, your love of self, your love of God, you know, and it's wonderful when we have the love of God to love ourselves so we can love our neighbors as ourselves, so we don't use the neighbor as a punching bag or a place of deflecting negative feelings on the neighbor, or the neighbor becoming a scapegoat of feelings for all the stuff that's going on inside of you, that insecurity. You don't have to use your neighbor to step on him to feel good about you, because you don't have that much. You love your God, and you love yourself, so you can love your neighbor as yourself, making love your highest aim by first loving God. And God is love. It says, I can't really think of the verse, 4:8, where's the book? Anyway, it says, God is love, right? So, making love our highest aim puts us in good company, because God is love. God so loved the world. So God is love. God is a noun, love. You know, that's a positive. God is love. God, you know, it's an adjective for God, but it is also who He is and what He does. He is this, not just regular love, like, oh, I love you, baby. You know, He is lava, white hot, pugnacious, never let you go love. He is the frequency, the essence, the totality of mind-blowing love, right? He's love. And so when we make love our highest aim, we put ourselves in the company of the God who is love, who so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth shall not perish but have everlasting life. Because God didn't come in this world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. Why? Because God so loved the world. He said, like Walter Jackson, let me place my love upon your pain. Tell me where it hurts. He said, come to me who are all heavy laden, and I will give you rest. And take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for my yoke is easy and my burdens are light. He said, I know the stuff you're under. I know the sin, the shame, the guilt, and all that low frequency stuff. And it's waiting you, you know. You know, your body cam is coding it back to you. You know, but He says, let me place my love and bring healing. So as we make love our highest aim, we put ourselves in a place of healing and transformation. We are our better selves when we love We are a place of healing when we love, because perfect love casts out fear. And when we cast out fear, then faith can operate in its fullness, you know, in its totality. And it can, if faith works, is it works best through love, is activated through love. Love that conquers all. That kind of love. And so love is transforming and it is healing. And God is love. And it is, and God commands us to love. And he says to us, make love our highest aim. So I encourage you on your things to do list, don't forget to love. You say, what's love got to do with it? Got a lot to do with it, because God is love. For God so loved. And what is love? And you go to Corinthians and says, love bears all, believes all, hopes all. It says, love is not easily offended, doesn't demand its own way. I mean, that's the homework if you want to know, what can I do to make this world a better place? By starting with you and starting with choosing to love. Now, you ain't got to like everybody. You don't have to agree with everybody. You don't have to be a doormat. You know, it doesn't mean you don't walk away and get out of some things you shouldn't be in or because they're dangerous. You know, but it doesn't mean I'm going to stop loving you and wish you ill. You may not even think about the person, but you're not going to wish them ill. You know, you're going to pray for them. You're going to wish the best for them, and you're just going to move on, and move on in the spirit of love. You know, so that was a season. I learned what I need to learn, and I wish them well as they move forward. You know, God bless you. Please put it on your, consider putting it on your things to do list, making love your highest aim. And whatever you do in word or deed, do it in his name. Do it in the essence of love.